guests. Thank you for coming to this meeting. Notice I hand up a calendar here, indication of what happening with my title, Chinese New Year. First of all, Happy New Year to everybody. But today I would like to lecture you, perhaps entertain you even, about the origin of Chinese New Year. Obviously, I'm not going to go through a calendar. This is a Western calendar. You notice anything red is a holiday. So on the 25th, if you can see it, that is the first day of a new year for Chinese New Year. Now, where is Chinese New Year come from? Is it really a new year? Long story short, perhaps since thousands and thousands and thousands of years ago, there's a legend about a myth called Nian. Nian is not actually pronounced as what we interpret it nowadays. Now, to help you familiarize with it, I'm going to write it down. Thanks. Hopefully you can read my handwriting. This is the English word for the word Nian in Chinese. Nian used to be known as a monster that's roaming around villages, Chinese towns, cities, that always come to haunt them towards that time around the end of January. Always coming here to attack villages, always come here to eat the possession from the people and also animals. It creates a lot of horror, a lot of issues. Nian is the monster that the villagers try to overcome. But time and time again, year and year again, the villager failed to defeat the monster. Nian is the monster, and when the villager describe about going through the dealing with the monster, there's another word called guo. Well, I can write it down. Meaning pass over. So in English, that means pass, passing, or passage, or a avenue to go through to deal with this monster. So, guo nian in Chinese, meaning passing nian. Nian now is known as the year, but at the time was known as the monster. So the villagers consulted outside. They don't know what to do. Everything was destroyed. Then one year coming up, thousands of years ago, there's a legend. There's a wisdom from God coming down from the heaven to earth to advise what's the best way to defeat this Nian. What's the best way to conquer this fear? The wisdom tell them simply, dress everything up in red. See my tie here today? See that? It's in red. Everything is in red. A pen. Red is something that Nian is afraid of. You think about the Spanish bulldog. They love red, correct? If you go to the Spanish aquarium, they understand what that means. Red is something attract, but Nian is afraid of the color red. Another thing the wisdom from God have taught to the villagers is to propose using loud music. Loud, not talking about rap music. Talking about really loud, using, remember the cymbal, Chinese cymbal, and the drums, and the firecracker, what do they generate? A lot of noise. A lot of noise that Nian is afraid of. So these are the two advice. And the third is to hand a diagram. Now, an example of that diagram is look like this. This is a Chinese character meaning fu, meaning being pleasant, but fu also means it's an adversary of Nian. There's a lot of, if you study Chinese, I know Danny's not today, but study Chinese, you understand there's a parallel universe. Words are paired up together well, and there are words that do not pair very well. These are adversary. So hand around the sign of this Chinese character in front of your door of your house helps to sway the monster here. So the villager did accordingly, and everybody team up, and they put a lot of red signs, dress up in red costumes, and also handing a bunch of, paint the house red, handing a bunch of red character, including the goblin, and also to figure out what's the best spot to put it. Then they hunt a bunch of firecrackers on the site. And when Nian attacked at night, they light them up. Imagine what happened when firecracker goes around. There's a lot of noise, but there's also a lot of flame, the fire. Imagine Nian is also afraid of light. So Nian got scared away, going around, and eventually got defeated. And then the villagers celebrated. They celebrated with the God giving them wisdom during passing the year, passing Nian. They now had a tradition. Every Chinese New Year, you're going to hand everything red. You're gonna light up with firecracker. You're gonna paint a house red. Everything, including the red pockets and the red symbol. The symbol of red is very important for Chinese New Year. It also symbolizes Guonian, meaning that passage of the monster, passage of the year, passage of a new year, meaning that it will bring good luck. When you bring in a red sign, when you bring in a red gesture, everything is vibrant to you. Lighting a firecracker is a gesture of goodwill, a good luck, health, prosperity, and so forth. How is this story related to us in America? If you think about it, each year we have our fear. We have something that we really fear the most, the challenge we want to overcome. Just like the villager, thousands of years, even in a mythical legend, that they want to conquer. What is our fear? What is our nian? What is our nian this year? This is not word of the day, but again, this provides you with a very invaluable lessons from this story. We have our own nian. We have our own fear. Think about, be creative each year to ask, to go out, to learn about how to solve it, to learn about why it is important. Not only conquering the monster within us, but also conquering the monster that we have unforeseen for this coming year. Fellow Toastmaster guests, next Friday is on the 24th, and I would like all of you to enjoy what this means about Chinese New Year, what this festivity means. So I will be the Toastmaster for next Friday's meeting, and if anybody willing to help out, bring some food, do some small decorations to get it very well acquainted. I'm also a former member of Transpiration Toastmaster. We did a Chinese New Year theme meeting last year in February 2019. Happy to share some of that information further. But again, to learn about Chinese New Year, a 5 to 7 minutes story, do no justice. You have to experience it. So now with the red light coming up that I'm feeling as well, I would like to hand it back to our Toastmaster, and I would like to ask all of you to experience this culture from Chinese culture. What is the true meaning of Chinese New Year? And let's do this for Independent Speaking Club on next Friday. Mr. Toastmaster.